We're starting section 5 of chapter 6, which looks at numbers on the coordinate plane. I introduced this earlier when I introduced the chapter, but now we're going to concentrate on just looking at the coordinate plane. So write this down in your notebook. If you need to pause the video while you copy this all down, and then you can listen as I talk with your notes. So the coordinate plane is formed by the intersecting of vertical and horizontal lines. So remember, vertical is up and down, horizontal is left and right. These lines intersect at the origin, which is at 0, 0. So if you see my coordinate plane down here, I have the origin, we have the y-axis, we have the x-axis, and please label each coordinate in the coordinate plane as 1, Roman numeral 1, 2, Roman numeral 3, and Roman numeral 4. Those are very important. We're going to use those later. So copy this down. If you need to pause the video. When you're ready to move on, go ahead and move on. So we just copied this down, so now you're just going to look at this. So you do not need to copy this down. So the coordinate plane is divided into those four regions that we just labeled. So again, it's region Roman numeral 1, Roman numeral 2, Roman numeral 3, and Roman numeral 4. And we're going to have to memorize those. So remember, it goes 1, 2, 3, 4 in a counterclockwise way. So we're going to do some practice now. So we're going to practice graphing using ordered pairs. So remember, ordered pairs are x and y. So you're going to copy this all down into your notebook. So again, if you need to pause the video while you copy everything down, that might be a better idea, because then you can listen to me after you have all of your notes written. So I'm graphing using ordered pairs. So I want to graph the following on the coordinate plane. So I'm going to start with negative 4 and 5. So remember, the x always comes first, and x is horizontal, and y is vertical, so y to the sky. So I want a negative 4, so I'm going to come over to negative 4, and then I'm going to go up to positive 5. So over to negative 4, up to positive 5, and I'm going to put my dot there, and then I'm actually going to label that negative 4 and 5, and I actually should give it a letter, so I'm going to label that A. Okay, now we're going to graph another one. So let's graph B. So I'm going to go from 0, I always start at the origin. I'm going to go over to positive 6 and down to negative 3. And that's going to be my next spot. And I'm going to label that B with the coordinates of 6 and negative 3. All right, we're going to keep graphing. So now we're going to graph C. Find a fun color for C. So C, we're going to go to negative 5. So I'm going to go all the way to negative 5 and down to negative 3. So I'm going to go down to negative 3, put my dot. I'm going to label this C, negative 5, negative 3. And then my last one that I want to graph, we make that D. So I'm going to go over to positive 2 and up to 6. Put my dot, we'll label that D with the coordinates. So now if you remember from the last slide, if I want to know which coordinate these are all in, I'm going to first label them. So I start upper right, that's 1, 2, Roman numeral 3, and Roman numeral 4. So if I wanted to know which coordinate A is in 2, B is in 4, C is in 3, and D is in 1. So this should all be in your notebook. You don't have to use different colors, but if that helps, go right ahead. So if you need to pause the video. When you're ready to move on, go ahead and move on. Okay, so you're going to copy this down into your notebook. This is example 1. We're going to write an ordered pair that corresponds to each of the points in the coordinate plane. So we're going to start with A. So I have found A to be down here. So A, to get to A, I came over a positive 4 and down a negative 1. So A, I came over a positive 4 and down a negative 1. All right, so now let's do B. How did I get to B? Well, B, I went negative 2. And then positive 3. So B is negative 2, positive 3, if I want to write them as points in the coordinate plane. All right, let's look at C. So to get to C, I had to go over, so negative 4, and down negative 4. So C is negative 4, negative 4. And let's do the last one. D, I didn't go left or right. I stayed at the 0, and then I came down to negative 3. So my coordinates are 0, negative 3. So again, if you need more examples to help you understand this, there are different examples in your textbook. And you can look in your textbook on page 276. Look at example 1. And they'll have other examples to help you understand what to do. So copy this down into your notebook. So you're going to do some on your own. So if we copy down the whole, just make a quick rough graph and copy down 1, 2, 3, and 4. So write down your answers in your notebook. And then also you should see the text box to the right. So you remember you're writing these as ordered pairs. So we're using parentheses. We put the X first, a comma, and then we put the Y. So we're using the numbers to represent where P, Q, R, and S are on our graph. Okay, example 2. Plot the ordered pairs and describe their location in the coordinate plane. So we kind of did that in the previous slides. So we should be able to do this. So I'm going to go to A. So I want to go. A says to go negative 2 and then positive 3. So I'm going to go negative 2, positive 3, and I'm going to label that spot. So now if I look at B, I'm not going to go left or right. I'm going to stay at the 0, but I'm going to go down to negative 3. So right there is my next spot, and I'm going to label that as B. Try to get a bigger circle there for you. Okay, so now we want to graph C. So C, I want to go to negative 5, and then I want to go to negative 3. Put my circle. There's my letter. All right, last one. So we have D. We want to go positive 4, positive 5, put a little spot, and there we have D. So copy that into your notebook. Again, if you need another example on how to do this, you can look at a different example on page 277, which will show you the same idea, just using different numbers. And then the last thing we want to do is we want to describe their location in the coordinate plane. So remember their location. This is coordinate 1, 2, 3, and 4. So letter A is in Roman numeral 2. B is in Roman numeral, gosh, where would that be? So letter B is right on the y-axis, so we're going to say on the y-axis, because it's not in any coordinates planes. And then C is in Roman numeral 3, and D is in Roman numeral 1. Okay, so in your notebook, you're writing this down. You're going to draw your coordinate plane. You're going to graph all of these locations. You can label them 5, 6, 7, and 8, so I should see that in your notebook. And then on the text box to the right, you're just going to describe the location of each point. So is that in Roman numeral 1, Roman numeral 2, Roman numeral 3, or Roman numeral 4? If you need to, pause the video when you're ready to move on. First, answer the questions in the text box on the right, and then go ahead and move on. Okay, so now we have a word problem. We have so copy this into your notebook. So if you need to pause the video, I would pause the video, copy things down, and then listen when you're ready, after everything's been copied down. So we have an interior designer maps out a room design using a coordinate plane in which each unit represents 1 yard. The corners of the room are located at those 4 points. What are the dimensions of the room? Okay, well, let's do our points first. So first we're going to go negative 3, positive 2, and put a dot. Then we're going to go positive 5, positive 2, and put a dot. And now we're going to go positive 5, negative 3, and put a dot. And then we're going to go negative 3, and put a dot. And then if I connect all my dots, now I have a rectangular shape. And what are the dimensions of the room? So I can count the number of boxes. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So that's 8 by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 8 by 5. So remember, each unit represents 1 yard. So we have 8 feet by 5 feet for the dimensions of our room. So copy this down in your notebook. Again, if you need another example that's similar but using different numbers, you can go to page 277 in your textbook. It will give you another example to help understand. And then when you're ready to move on, go ahead and hit play and move on. So now you're going to do one of these on your own. So copy this down. Make your coordinate plane in your notebook. So an archaeologist finds a gold coin at this spot, a silver coin at that spot, and pottery at a different spot. So you want to find out the distance between some of these to answer the question. So how much closer is the pottery to the silver than to the gold? So you're going to answer that question in your notebook and then put your answer in the text box on the right. Again, if you need another example, go ahead and look at page 277 and they will give you an example to help support your understanding. Okay, now we're going to make a line graph. We're going to make a line graph of the following data points. So we have hours after midnight. So we're just plotting these in the coordinate plane. So they always give you the x first and then the y. So I'm going to go 0 to the x. So I'm not going to go left or right. I'm going to go straight up to 7, put my dot. And then I'm going to go over to 1, up to 5. We practiced this in science class, but we're going to practice it some more. 2 and 3. 3 and 0. 4 and negative 1. I go over to 5 and negative 4. And negative 4. I go over to 6 and negative 5. So I'm now going to connect the dots. And that's my line graph showing hours after midnight and the temperature. So what can you say about the temperature after hours of midnight? The temperature decreases after midnight. So copy this down into your notebook. Again, if you need another example, you can go to page 278 and they'll give you a very similar example just using different numbers. Okay, now on your own, so in your notebook, very similar, we're going to make a graph. Yes, you do need to get some negative numbers, but not for time. So hours after noon, that's your x, and temperature is your y. So go ahead and plot this. Now, there is no text box on the right because you can't really enter in a graph. So I'm going to look to see that these are in your notebooks tomorrow. So pause the video, do your graph, and then go ahead and move on. Okay, so we finished that. So what questions still remain? So are you able to plot things in the, can you plot in the coordinate plane? Do you know where Roman numerals 1, 2, 3, and 4 are in the coordinate plane? And are you able to make a line graph? Okay, so we're going to go over these again tomorrow with some more practice. If you have questions, please write them here in your notebook, and we can look at those tomorrow during class.